Lord, you're mighty. God, lift up your praises.
Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before. What a mighty God we serve.
Clap your hands, everybody. Come on. If God's been faithful, then sing along with us. Everybody say faithful.
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 Faithful,
faithful is
faithful
our God.
Is our God.
Come on, all over the world.
Faithful.
Say faithful.
Faithful,
faithful,
faithful
is our God.
Is our God.
Come on, say faithful.
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 Faithful,
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 is, our
faithful
God.
Is our God.
Yes, He is. Come on, say faithful.
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 Faithful,
faithful, is our God.
Faithful is our God.
I'm reaping the harvest.
I'm reaping the harvest God promised me.
Take back what the devil stole from me. And I rejoice today.
For
I shall recover it all.
Yes, I rejoice today. Faithful, faithful, faithful is our God.
Look at somebody and say, and yet I'm still saved.
And yet I'm still saved.
Walked in here this morning. Look at your feet and point to them and say, thank you, Lord, that you got feet to walk. You got a voice to talk. How many of you had a place to sleep last night? Aren't you blessed? Aren't you blessed? And yet there are some people always complaining. I don't care what mama used to say, we'd be crying with a loaf of bread on the hall. I heard a story the other day that there were some folks just like us on their way to church, all dressed up, Bible under their arm, looking sanctimonious, but they were complaining. Here's old Wino. Wasn't dressed up, didn't have no Bible, wasn't on his way to church, but I heard him say, I'm blessed. Woo! And it's just good to wake up in the morning and know that you're blessed. I'm truly blessed.
Mercy,
do you have the victory?
The victory.
Hey, hey.
said, bless you, yes. Would you get on your feet and tell somebody, come on, don't be ashamed, go and tell somebody. Find somebody and tell them you're blessed. Hey, I'm blessed.
Jesus. Jesus reigns. Good morning, Emmanuel Pearlgate family and friends. I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ on today as we proclaim the praise to God that comes from Psalm 105, which says, "For the Lord is good, his steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations." Whether you are at home or at your office or wherever you may be, happy Sunday to all of you as we come together virtually to praise and magnify our Lord. Emmanuel Pearlgate family and friends, thank you for continuously supporting this ministry and fellowshipping with us by tuning in. Believe me when I say I don't take it lightly that you choose to worship with us. Happy 61st anniversary, Emmanuel Pearlgate. God has truly been good to us. His favor has encompassed this ministry for many years, and we glorify him and we praise him for being a provider and a keeper for all of these years. Since 1959, we've been blessed to be led by some powerful men of God, starting with Pastor W.L. Hudson, then Pastor James E. Spencer, and Pastor Isaac Flippin, and recently Pastor Wade Hampton Sr. We've been taught and raised by great men and women who instilled in us the foundation of the gospel and the love of Jesus Christ. And because of that foundation, we can still feel the spirit-filled worship of Mother Hampton and Mother Chapman. We can still see the warm smiles of Sister Hankton and Sister King. We can still feel the love and the care of Sister Mary Jane Ratley and Reverend Walker. Our ears still ring of the voices of Deacon Meyer, Sister Gillies, and Sister Meeks. And our hearts are still filled by the lessons that were taught to us by Reverend and Sister Hampton, Deacon and Sister Love, and Reverend and Sister Rollins. So many people have touched the fabric of this ministry, in which so many young people, boys and girls, have grown in God, have accepted Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, and so many of our young men and women have become pastors, ministers, deacons, Sunday school teachers, and cultural and social role models. Emmanuel Pearlgate, we thank God for keeping us these 61 years, but we know that we are just getting started. I want to invite all of you to stay connected with us by visiting our Facebook page, our YouTube channel, our podcast channel, or by simply logging into our website at www.epbcsf.com. You know, due to this COVID-19 pandemic, we have been away from the sanctuary and we've been away from each other for a long time. And it's unbearable sometimes to think about just how long we've been away from each other, unable to worship our God in the sanctuary, not being able to love on each and every single one of you. But it has been wise for us to stay away, to stay safe, and to stay connected with each other over the waves and over virtual land. The virus is still rising here in the Bay Area, and so it's even wiser for us to continue to stay away. I praise God on this morning that we've been able to worship and we've been able to continue to grow together virtually. And that is exactly what we will continue to do until further notice. But make sure and be assured that when we do return, we will come back safer, we will come back stronger, and we'll be able to continue to grow together in the love of God. Remember, this month is All Black Everything Month, so please do your very best to support Black-owned businesses. I know that it is definitely not an easy thing to do, but just put your best foot forward. Go to our website, under the upcoming events tab, and you will find a list of black-owned businesses that you can choose from. So let's show this country the power of the black dollar and let them know that we are valuable and we are important in the fabric of this society. We will continue in our worship service on today with our altar call and with a song selection. And then I will be back with a word from the Lord. Come on, let's worship our God together. It is now time for our altar call prayer. We pray for those who are sick. We pray for those who are hurting, those who are in pain, those who are in grief. We pray for the Emanuel Pearlgate family, and we pray for all those who, for some reason or another, cannot pray for themselves. Let us go to our Lord in prayer. Dearly Father, we thank you on today for always being there right beside us. We thank you for waking us up every single morning. We thank you, O God, for keeping us in our right state of mind. We praise your name on today because you have continuously shown yourself to be a God of grace and a God of mercy. God, we thank you for keeping us during these rough times. Thank you, O God, for keeping your protective hands, your protection all around us. We thank you for lifting us up where we are torn down. We thank you, O God, for loving us enough that you have shown yourself to be a God who is all sovereign and a God who has all control in his hands. We come to you right now, O God, because we definitely need you in our lives. We need you to continuously make a way. We need you, O God, to continuously lift us up. We need you, O God, right now, O God, to continuously heal our sick bodies, mend our confused minds, put back together our broken hearts, to console our grieving hearts, to continue, O God, to put together broken families. We need you right now, O God, to just move miraculously in our lives. We need you right now, O God, to go into the streets of our city. We need you to go into the hospitals right now, O God. We need you, O God, right now to take care of our homeless. We need you right now, O God, to move in a mighty way in our prison yard. We need you right now, O God, to go into our government systems and just move and just let them know that they are not in control, but you are in fact in control. Let them, O God, seek your guidance and seek your word so that they may know what it is that they must do in these times, the times that the people are looking to you. O God, we just thank you on today. We thank you for allowing the doors of Emanuel Pearlgate Baptist Church to be open for 61 years. And we are trusting in you, O God, that you will continue to be with us as we strive to continue to do what you have called for us to do. Let us, O God, continue to be the beacon light in this community and throughout the world, so we can tell dying souls that they can come to you and their lives can be saved. O God, we come to you right now, O God, to continue, O God, to be with the Love family. Continue, O God, to be with the Rattler family. Continue, O God, to be with the Pope family. Continue, O God, to be with the Wade family. Continue, O God, to be with every single member of this church house. Continue, O God, to be with every single household that is represented here on today. For we know, O God, that you're able to do all things but fail. And you're able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we could ever ask or think. We thank you, O God, in advance, and we praise your name in advance, not just for the things that you have done and the things that you're doing even right now, but we praise you for the things that you are going to do in the near future. We ask all these things in Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Father. Amen. Dearly Father, we thank you on today for your many blessings. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your grace. We thank you, O God, for this opportunity that you've given to us so that we may hear a word from you. Give us a word, O God, that will edify us, that will encourage us, that will make us better day in and day out. We ask all these things in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Good morning to each and every one of you, to Pastor Wade Hampton Sr., to Evangelist Wade, and also to Reverend Dante Polk. I count it all joy to be in the house of the Lord on today. Amen. The message on today will be coming from the book of Job, chapter 14, verses 7 through 9. The word of our Lord speaks to us as follows. For there is hope of a tree. If it be cut down, that it will sprout again, and that the tender branch thereof will not cease. Though the root thereof wax old in the earth, and the stock thereof die in the ground, yet through the scent of water it will bud and bring forth boughs like a plant. May the Lord bless the reading and the hearing of his most precious word. I want to use that scripture on today to speak to you using the subject, hope in a tree. Hope in a tree. The blessing of being a child of God is knowing that we have hope. Even when the whole world seems to be losing hope, we can gather ourselves underneath the umbrella of God's love and God's grace and stand on that blessed assurance of hope. Here we are celebrating the fact that God has been with us, the Emanuel Pearlgate Baptist Church, for 61 years. And even though these have been hard times, when we face trials, even though there has been times when we face obliteration, even though times have been bleak and uncertain, God has shown his mercy and he's shown his favor towards us. Therefore, we can declare from experience that in spite of what may be going on all around us, we have hope. And I wonder if there is anybody who is listening on today who can make that declaration this morning that you have hope in God. Yes, we go through trials and tribulations. Yes, we have gone through our share of pain, suffering, and grief. Yes, we have lost jobs and are having financial struggles. Yes, we are in the midst of a deadly pandemic, but there is hope. And I need somebody today who could testify with me that no matter what we may be going through, we have hope because God continues to wake us up every single morning. We have hope because God continues to keep us in our right state of mind. We have hope because even though the enemy has tried to shut us down, has tried to shut us out, and has tried to mute the gospel, we are still here proclaiming to the world that God is love, God is Lord, and God is King. We have hope because we trust in the promises of God, knowing that he cannot lie and that he can do all things but fail. We have hope on today because even though we are surrounded by diverse temptations, we can count it all joy because God continues to strengthen us. God continues to provide for us. God continues to protect us. God continues to heal us. God continues to be with us. And as a matter of fact, we discovered that every time we turn around, God is still blessing us. Is there anybody in virtual land on today who can give God glory and can give God praise? Because you discovered that as long as you are a child of God, and as long as God is in control and he is still on the throne,
we can have hope. In this text, we find a child of God who finds himself in the midst of his own pandemic. This man by the name of Job was once the wealthiest man in the world. He was blessed with many cattle and oxen. He was blessed with houses and land. He was blessed with beautiful children, and he was blessed with a beautiful wife. Job had everything anybody could ever ask for. He had his health, he had his strength, and he had a great relationship with God. But all of Job's blessings only lasted for a little while, because Satan sought to prove to God that Job was only faithful to God because of the blessings God bestowed upon him. And through the allowance of God, Job lost everything. He lost his riches. He lost his cattle and oxen. He lost his houses and land. All of his children had died. His wife and his friends turned their backs on him. And on top of all of that, Job was stricken with sickness and disease. Job is going through so much hardship that he declares that it would have been better if he wasn't even born. This church, too, has had its moments of glory and growth. But we went through moments of hardships as well. And even in the present moment, we are going through a pandemic. And like Job, we too may have feelings of doubt. We may have feelings of worry. We may have feelings of giving up. But we have hope. And I wonder if I'm talking to anybody in virtual land who has also gone through your Job moment, who find themselves in the midst of a rut, who find themselves in the midst of a tragedy, who finds themselves in the midst of their own moments of despair. May I suggest to you on today that as long as you have Jesus in your life, you have hope. Job, because of all the things that he was going through, he begins to question the value of a man's life, stating that man lives but for a little time. So why would God allow hardships to come? For there is no hope after death. During this time of history, Job has no knowledge of God's plan for salvation. So he begins to have doubt about the very purpose of life. He points to the very hope that a tree possesses, that even though a tree may go through its moments of hardships, trials, fires, floods, and even going through the trauma of being cut down, a tree can still have the ability to grow from its stump with the presence of living water. For those of you who may not know, a tree first grows down into the ground before it grows upward. Its roots dig themselves down, deep down into the ground, and then spreads itself outward to establish a strong foundation for the tree's period of growth. So no matter how strong the winds may blow, a tree can still stand. No matter how treacherous a flood may be, a tree can still stand. Even in the case of going through fire, a tree can still stand because it is rooted in a strong foundation. Job's faith in God was rooted in a strong foundation. That's why he could declare, "Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked will I return. The Lord giveth, and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." And because of Job's faithfulness, God returned to Job everything he had lost and so much more. And just like the roots of a tree, this church has a strong foundation. We have roots that are dug deep down into the soil, which has stood the test of time, which has been our strength and our foundation. This ministry is rooted in the strong foundation of the gospel of Jesus Christ. It's not built on the personality or the gift of a person. It's not built on music and entertainment. It's not built on folklore or false doctrine. But because the roots of this ministry is built on and dug deep in the foundation of the gospel and the love of Jesus Christ, we have hope. We have the hope that we will stand the test of time. We have hope that we will continue to grow. We have the hope and the blessed assurance that with the blood of Jesus Christ and the water that flows from the Holy Spirit, not only will we survive, but we shall rise again. Not only shall we rise again, but we will blossom and we will produce. We will produce love. We will produce saved souls. We will produce uplifted hearts. We will produce saved lives. We will produce the feeding of the hungry. We will produce the healing of the sick. We will produce the resurrection of what seemed to be dead. We will produce the defeat of the enemy. And I declare on today that this is not the end. This is only the beginning, because I declare that God has greater things in store for us. And may I suggest to you on today that you should have hope. I encourage you to establish your foundation in Jesus Christ. For in the foundation of Christ, you will be able to stand in the midst of the strongest of winds. You will be able to stand in the midst of the hottest fires. You will be able to stand in the midst of the raging storms and seas. If you plant your faith in the foundation of Jesus Christ, you'll be able to stand in the midst of this pandemic. If you plant your faith in the foundation of Jesus Christ, you will be able to declare that no weapons that are formed against me shall be able to prosper. You will be able to declare, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor has it gone into the thoughts of man, the thing that God is getting ready to do in my life. For I hope that God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we could ever ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. May I tell you why we have hope. We have the hope of a tree, but we also have the hope in a tree. The same tree that grew in the plains of Jerusalem. The same tree that was cut down and produced into two beams. The same tree that was placed on the back of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We have the hope of the tree. The same tree in which Jesus' hands and feet were nailed onto. The same tree that was lifted up high. The same tree in which Jesus hung his head and died for the sins of a dying world. And I'm so glad on today that I can have hope in the tree, because even though the enemy tried to cut the tree down, early one Sunday morning, Jesus got up once again with all power in his hands. And I'm so glad on today that we have hope. Even when the storms rage, we have hope. Even when the fires of life does its best to destroy us, we have hope. Even when the pestilence of hateful people try to discourage us, we have hope. B Because every single day, every single moment of our lives, we are in the midst, in the presence of living water, which is the Holy Spirit. And He helps me to grow. He helps me to produce. For He walks with me and He talks with me. And I don't know about you, but I can't help but have hope, knowing that as long as I have King Jesus, I don't need anybody else, and I don't need anything else, for I am safe in the arms of the Lord. I encourage you today, have your foundation dug deep into the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Believe that He is our Lord and Savior. Believe that He came to die just for you. Believe in the simple fact that if you have the Lord with you, nothing can knock you down. Nothing can tear you apart. Nothing can defeat you, because you have the foundation of the Lord in your life. You know that you have God behind you. You know that you have Jesus in front of you. You know that you have the Holy Spirit within you. And you know, and you have hope and a promise that on each side of you, you have grace and mercy. And you are surrounded by the love of Jesus Christ. So don't throw in the towel. Don't give up. Just know that in God, you have hope. And it's in this hope that we know that God will take care of you. God bless you, and may God keep you.
The Bible says, God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish but have eternal life. That's in John 3:16. Jesus said, I came that they may have life and have it more abundantly, a complete life full of purpose, John 10:10. But here's the problem. People are sinful and separated from God. We have all done wrong, thought or said bad things, which the Bible calls sin. The Bible says all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God, Romans 3:23. The result of sin is death. Spiritual separation from God, Romans 6:23. The good news? God sent His Son to die for your sins. Jesus died in our place so we could have a relationship with God and be with Him forever. God demonstrates His own love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. That's Romans 5:8. But it didn't end with His death on the cross. He rose again and He still lives. Christ died for our sins. He was bruised. He was raised on the third day, according to Scripture, 1 Corinthians 15:3 and 4. Jesus is the only way to God. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but through me, John 14:6. Would you like to receive God's forgiveness? We can't earn salvation. We are saved by God's grace when we have faith in His Son, Jesus Christ. All you have to do is believe that you are a sinner, that Christ died for your sins, and ask for His forgiveness. Then turn from your sins. That's called repentance. Jesus Christ knows you and loves you. What matters to Him is the attitude of your heart, your honesty. We suggest praying the following prayer to accept Christ as your Savior. If you're willing to do this, repeat this prayer after me. Dear God, I know that I am a sinner, and I ask for your forgiveness. I believe Jesus Christ is your Son. I believe that He died for my sins, and that you raised Him on the third day with all power and glory. I want to trust Him as my Savior and follow Him as my Lord from this day forward. Guide my life and help me to do your will. I pray this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. If you just prayed this prayer, You are now covered in the blood of Jesus. Don't worry about trying to be perfect, because you're not going to be perfect. Just trust God. He's going to guide you. He's going to help you every step of the way. God bless you.
Why don't you tonight? While you have time, don't be ashamed. If you know you need to be right with God, make a step tonight. Come on. Oh Lord. That's it. That's it. That's it. Don't let nothing stop you tonight. Make up your mind.
We pray that you were immensely blessed by the word of God on today. If you have given your life over to the Lord, feel free to let us know by putting in a comment or by emailing us or by visiting us on our website at epbcsf.com. And if for any reason you don't have a church home and the Holy Spirit has led you to us, feel free to, once again, let us know. We are eager to put our arms around you, to love you, and to nurture you in the Word of God. For this is a church where everyone is family. We're going to continue to worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ through our giving. We have the way of giving through the Cash App. You can give with $ Emanuel Pearlgate, or you can simply mail in your tithe or offering at 19 Bayview Street in the city of San Francisco, California, 94124.
Thank you for joining in with us in this special virtual worship service. Stay connected with us by visiting our Facebook page, our YouTube channel, our podcast channel, or by simply logging into our website at epbcsf.com. Once again, happy anniversary, Emanuel Pearlgate. God has some great things in store for us, and I just can't wait to see what He does. So make sure to stay safe, love on each other, and most importantly, keep your hands in God's hands, and He will never let go of you. May the grace of God and the sweet communion of His Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with us henceforth, now and forevermore, to do His most perfect will. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Remember, I love you, and there's absolutely nothing you could do about it. Until next time, God bless you.
I said